Hi guys, so today I have another tutorial for you, this time for installing NetHunter on Nexus 5X. So, first of all, go to Chrome and type in this address. It's debug Nexus root toolkit. Just scroll down and choose to download. Now press begin download. And now choose the mirror that is closest to you. Mine is Europe. Now just install. Press run. And install it. Okay. Now connect your phone to the PC. Go to settings. Scroll down and press about phone. Scroll down again and tap build number 7 times to become a developer. Go back and choose developer options. Go down and enable USB debugging. Press OK. Also enable OEM unlocking. We'll need this for later to unlock our bootloader. Now go back to Nexus root toolkit and press auto detect device plus build. If that doesn't work, just select the device you have. Mine is Nexus 5X and the Android build you can check in settings. Go back, press about phone. And just scroll down and check the build number. Mine is MMB29K. Just find your build, click and apply. Press OK. The TWRP recovery is not present, so just press download. Now let's close this up. First thing we need to do is to unlock the bootloader, so press unlock here. And remember, all of your data on your phone will be erased, so back everything up before you continue. Press OK. And if this pops up, no ADB or fastboot device is found, just go to your phone. Press OK to allow USB debugging. And now press this, USB for charging, and press file transfer. And allow USB debugging again. Close this and press OK. And it should up reboot your device in the bootloader and start to unlock it. Now use your volume up key to select yes and press the power button. And now your bootloader is unlocked. It just has to wipe your phone first. Okay, now we type in our PIN and let's skip through the setup. Now you have to enable USB debugging again, so go down, about phone, build number 7 times, developer options, and press USB debugging, OK, press OK. Okay, so now we have to root our phone, just press root here. press OK. And the fastboot device wasn't found again. So let's try changing this to NTP again. Press OK. And try again. If you don't have BusyBox on your phone, just go to Play Store. Type in BusyBox and download it. Then go to it, open it up, grant permission, exit this, and just leave it as it is and press install. Okay, and that's it. Now follow this link. Here you'll find NetHunter builds for Nexus 5. For Marshmallow and Nougat, but I used Marshmallow for this one. There's an option to have the full or the minimal version of NetHunter, so I chose full, and all credits go to Shaistie for building this. Just press here, begin download, and choose the mirror you want. I already have it downloaded, so I'll close this up, and I have it here. So now you have an option to do it manually, to go to computer, open your Nexus 5 and copy it in your internal storage, or you can simply go to Advanced Utilities, press Launch, press Flash Zip Files From, press OK, choose Add Zips to Flash, and find the zip file, press Open, and confirm operation, press OK, and that's it. Now to go to your phone. Just wait. It will restart in the bootloader and it will start flashing. Swipe here and wait. Okay, so now you have NetHunter 3.0 installed. Okay, so now you can just type in your PIN, press OK, and if you see that NetHunter, that you don't have all the options available with the NetHunter, like it is here, then just press here, check app update, you go back with NetHunter, press here, grant permission. And it will update it. And now you have everything accessible.
And for some final notices, if at any point, maybe when you're unlocking the bootloader, you're rooting the phone, or when you're installing the NetHunter, if whenever you get stuck or you think you're stuck, just wait a couple of minutes, like 5 or 10, and if nothing changes, then just close the Nexus root toolkit and restart the process you're currently doing, because it may happen that it crashes a few times during the process, so the whole process shouldn't take more than like 2 hours. If it takes more than that, you're probably stuck somewhere, so just go through the steps again and see if you did anything wrong.